Good afternoon and happy Easter, everybody. I'm Dave Douglas, and welcome to Boston Celtics basketball on Sports Channel. Today, the Celtics host the New Jersey Nets. Tip off down at Boston Garden, just about 15 minutes away. Now, only 2 weeks remain in the regular season. I know you're as anxious for the playoffs to begin as we are, but for now, we'll concentrate on the 9 remaining games on the schedule.
The longest homestand of the season comes to an end today after 2 weeks of sleeping in their own bed, eating their own food, and seeing their own family. It might be hard to get these guys back on an airplane.
Ray, our trainer, just informed us that we have a game Monday away in Cleveland, and you can find everybody almost just not willing to go. So it does feel good. We needed a long homestand. We went out for 2 weeks, 2.5 weeks in February. Then we came back 2 days or 3 days and went out a week and a half longer. So it feels real good.
How does the head coach spend his time during a long homestand?
Babysit, help with the dishes and the cooking, and you know, the wives have been cooped up for a while, but just nice being home where you can relax and be on your own bed. You're not eating in the restaurant, and the players get a chance to just get back to their normal daily duties.
But don't worry, when the Celtics return to the road, their exploits away from Boston Garden have been almost as noteworthy as their near flawless home record. A big reason? Confidence.
Oh, I think it's, you know, the most important part, confidence, especially going into the playoffs. And you're going to have a lot of close games, and that, you know, that air of confidence and that confidence in each other is really, I think, is what's going to win your games down, you know, the close games.
But if you're at a level where you're going good and your confidence is high and your team is playing well, you know, that just takes you up a notch further. So it just makes you feel almost, when you get on the court, that you know you have to play, and you have to play very well to win. But almost any night, maybe one of your people may not have the best of games, but you're almost confident, and pretty sure you're confident that anybody behind him is going to step in and play just as well.
How would you compare the confidence on this team to the clubs you played with, the world champion teams?
The same level. We had some very cocky guys. And since 1958, Russell, Cousy, Sharman, right down the line. The nine years I played, I think we were the most cockiest team in the whole league for those 9 years. And this team matches that, which I like very much. But without being cocky, then you're not going to be as good as you are. You won't be thinking the game, or you won't be thinking ways to beat the other club. That's the only way to play the game. That way you operate with all the potential that you have. If you don't have that kind of confidence, then there will be a period there where you get a little shaky and the legs get a little wobbly, and then the eyes start rolling around a little bit. This is on par with the teams I've played.
With a record of 60 wins and 13 losses, these Celtics have every reason to be confident. Today, they'll be shooting for their 27th straight win at home. For more on this game, let's go live to Boston Garden. Join Mike Gorman and Tom Heintz in a beautiful Easter Sunday. Too bad you guys got to work indoors today.
Well, we're going to be out of here as quick as we can after this one's over, David. And a happy Easter Sunday to you and everybody watching. Welcome to this portion of the broadcast. Mike Gorman along with Tom Heintz. The Nets in town, a team, Tom, that probably maybe more so than the Houston Rockets has suffered under drugs in professional sports in the form of Michael Ray Richardson.
I think that coach Davey Wall brought Laker fast break basketball to the New Jersey Nets, and certainly Michael Ray Richardson was very adept at running that middleman spot, much like Magic Johnson, and perhaps even a better defensive player than Magic Johnson when it came to guarding somebody. So to lose a player of his caliber via the drug route, and it's a real sad thing for Michael Ray Richardson, of course, who's just has not been able to conquer that addiction, but also for his teammates who were relying a great deal on him, and his team has kind of disintegrated without Michael Ray.
Certainly has. Let's take a look at the Nets in action here. Some of the people may surprise you who have been stars for this Nets team, names like Jaminski, for one.
Well, with Darryl Dawkins being out of the lineup, Mike Jaminski has come to the fore. He has been probably the, until Walton showed up with the Celtics, the number one backup center in the league, and he's been moved up to the starting position most of this season, and he really has done an outstanding job. He's not a leaper, but he gets the job done. They love to run. They'll take it to you every time they can. What they're missing without Darryl Dawkins, however, is that strong inside game. They can get a little nippy on defense, too. Their weak side comes into play fairly well. And they've got some excellent outside shooters, Cook, Birdsong, and Calvin Ramsey. But they will take it to you, make you look at the ball, get it inside quickly, off the push-up fast, and situations like this develop.
Now, Jeff Turner, you saw on that action right there, has turned into the backup center for this team, which says a lot. The interesting decision by Dave Wall, though, Richardson goes down, Dawkins goes down. He's out on the floor and has been for the past few weeks with just 10 players. He decided not to make any replacements. As a coach, how do you look at that?
I think the two guys that they would bring in, perhaps because, you know, on a 10-day contract, really wouldn't help this ball club right now. That might disrupt it. So he's got 10 guys that'll play for his ball club right now. The most delicate spot for a playoff action for this club is that Darryl Dawkins, it appears, is not going to be ready for the playoffs. And without, if Jeff Turner is going to be their backup center, they got problems.
Okay, the Celtics come in with a 10-game winning streak and look to tie the Minneapolis Lakers for the longest home streak this afternoon, so we'll be talking about them plenty, Dave, in the next couple of hours.
Robert Parrish did not suit up for the last game. What's his status for today, Mike?
He's out there warming up right now and seemed to be pretty loose in the layup line, so we'll find out with the starting lineup how much he'll play and how much Bill Walton's going to play.
Okay, Bill Walton did get his first start of the season in the last outing. Okay, Mike and Tommy, we'll be back to you guys in just a couple of minutes. When we return, we'll take a look at the most recent outings for both the Celtics and Nets, and we'll run down today's NBA schedule. Stay with us.
Pontiac, among the hottest selling cars in General Motors 86 lineup, and Grand Am is the hottest Pontiac of them all. At your New England Pontiac dealers, you can buy the exciting new Grand Am Coupe with air, AM/FM stereo, and more for just $98.74, and that includes freight, or lease it for as little as $193 a month. Hurry while selection's at its best. Get the Pontiac hotter than all the rest. Grand Am, from your New England Pontiac dealers.
Boy, what a beautiful ride. Come into any one of my Sullivan Tire Car Care Centers for fast, friendly service on tires, shocks, battery, and brakes. Meet Vector, Goodyear's newest all-season radial. Its innovative crisscross tread provides year-long traction and long-term wear. So come in to any one of my Sullivan Tire Car Care Centers, say hello to Vector, and enjoy the ride of your life.
The Rock of Boston. 104 FM, WBCN.
Celtics fans, follow your favorite team year-round with Celtics Pride, the official fan magazine of the Boston Celtics. 20 exciting issues complete with columns by Red Auerbach, Casey Jones, and ML Carr. Color photographs, player profiles, and much, much more. Be an expert on pro basketball's premier team. Subscribe to Celtics Pride. For a year's subscription of 20 great issues, send $20 to Boston Celtics Pride, P.O. Box 9148, Boston, Mass. 02114. Be a part of the action. Subscribe today.
We're back on Sports Update. The Boston Celtics bring a 10-game winning streak into today's game. They've won 26 in a row at home. The numbers have been nothing short of staggering. The last outing for Boston, Friday night at the Garden against Washington, a game you saw here on Sports Channel. Bill Walton got his first start of the season. Off the DJ miss, Bill tears down a rebound and puts it back up strong, and he drew the foul. Here's a play that had Celtic brass holding their breath. Larry Bird dives, runs into the scorer's table, set up Danny Ainge for the three-point play. There it goes. Larry came right back, though. He didn't miss a second of action. Celtics led by 13 at the half. Off the loose ball, watch Jerry Seasting pick it up and race home for a nifty little layup. And he drew the foul. In the second half, Boston's game just kept getting stronger. Larry Bird will hit Dennis Johnson. Oh, that's a great pass underneath. DJ hits the turnaround. Boston beat the Bullets the other night, 116-97. Well, the New Jersey Nets come into today's game with a record of 36-39. They are a mere 25 games behind Boston in the Atlantic Division. First-year head coach Davey Wold has been really through the fires this year, what with the Michael Ray Richardson affair, Darryl Dawkins' season-ending injury, and the rest. That man deserves combat pay for what he's been through this year. The Nets' last outing was Friday night at home against Chicago.
gets the ball now low.
In that game, Chicago's Gene Banks made one down low to the Big O, Orlando Woolridge, for the dunk, but the Iceman gave Chicago a one-point first-half lead with this finger roll down the middle. But the Nets kept things even. Mike Jaminski, who'll be cheering for his alma mater, Duke, in Monday's NCAA final, fed Buck Williams underneath for a deuce. Then Kelvin Ranzi for New Jersey took advantage of some pretty slack Chicago defense right here, drove in for an easy layup. That's called uncontested. Nobody made a move on him. The Nets beat Chicago that night, 118-107. Here's your full NBA schedule for today. The Nets and Celts coming up from the Garden in just a couple of minutes. Dallas will be playing at Philadelphia. That's a 1 o'clock start. The Sixers will be without Moses Malone, not only for today, but for the rest of the regular season. Malone suffered an eye injury. In fact, the orbital bone around his eye socket was broken in a play the other night. Phoenix and Seattle, that game will start 10 o'clock tonight Eastern time. And the late game will be at the Fabulous Forum in Inglewood, California. The Lakers hosting the Golden State Warriors. The Lakers lost the other night, by the way, to Seattle, 88-87. Well, today on our post-game show, we'll continue with part four of the Celtics Dynasty Series. Today's segment includes one of the most famous plays in Celtics history, when John Havlicek intercepted a Hal Greer pass to save the Eastern Conference Championship.
As he lobbed it, I thought right away that I might have a chance to deflect it, intercept it, or whatever. And as this happened, I was able to go up and momentarily control it and deflect it to Sam Jones, who dribbled out the clock. Russell was the first one to get to me because he realized that he had been wearing the goat horns, and he said, "Thank you for taking those horns off the top of my head." And by that time, trying to get to the locker room was almost an impossibility, and the fans really got crazy. They started to rip at my jersey, and they did tear my jersey off. They were so jubilant about this victory.
A moment etched in the memory of every Celtics fan, the time Havlicek stole the ball. That's coming up on part four of our Celtics Dynasty Series. That'll be on our post-game show today. All right, as far as hockey action, the Hartford Whalers have the day off. They, at the moment, are tied with Buffalo for the final Adams Division playoff spot, both teams with 78 points. All right, that's going to do it for our pregame edition of Sports Update. Up next, the Celtics and the Nets from Boston Garden. We'll see you at halftime with all the scores.
Fantastic.
Thoroughbred racing. It's a part of New England heritage, and it's the sport of kings. Now, 5 days a week, Sports Channel keeps you up to date on all the day's races from one of New England's premier tracks, Suffolk Downs. There's a complete recap of each day's races, including the actual call, plus inside info and much more. Racing from Suffolk Downs comes your way Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and every weekend. You won't want to miss any of the excitement of another of our exclusive racing programs. Don't miss it right here on Sports Channel.
Boston Celtics basketball is brought to you by Bud Light, the light beer with the first name and taste. Everything else is just a light. By your New England Pontiac dealers, home of the hot ones for 1986. By Fleet National Bank, New England's financial resource. Remember, you can always bank on Fleet for the innovative services and personal attention you require. By NYNEX, business information systems, tying all your business communications together. By your New England Nissan Datsun dealers, where all you're going to hear is, yes, we can. By your neighborhood True Value hardware store. And by Sullivan Tire, family car care centers. At Sullivan Tire, you'll be treated with our family spirit, because that's what Sullivan Tire is all about. Welcome, everybody, to an Easter Sunday afternoon here at the Boston Garden, where this afternoon the Celtics are going to try and tie an NBA record for most consecutive wins at home, and the opposition will be the Nets out of New Jersey. Hi, everybody. I'm Mike Gorman, along with Tom Heinsohn. Happy Easter from both of us, and hope you enjoy Celtic basketball this afternoon. Again, the Celtics trying to set a record here, T.
Well, I think this is an undermanned New Jersey net team, but don't forget, you can't take the Nets lightly. I think the last week, the Celtics have played some pretty stiff competition in the Houston Rockets and the Milwaukee Bucks, so they're... intensity level still may be up there where they'll be able to handle a charge of the Nets.
All right, let's talk about the Nets a little bit. This is a club that is missing two key players in Michael Ray Richardson and Daryl Dawkins, and one player who has stepped to the fore in that absence may surprise a few people around the league. Mike Juminski has stepped in at the center, and you've always been a big booster of Juminski's time.
I think Juminski is one of the smartest players in the NBA, just a shade below intelligence-wise for the game, to Larry Bird. He plays his position with his head. He's not a great athlete, he's not a leaper, but he learned how to block out and create room for himself inside. Offensively, he's an excellent low post player, and he's also an excellent outside shooter when they pull the big guy outside and can pass the ball a boot.
The Bucks are an interesting team in that they have five players averaging between 15 and 16 points a game, so there is balance on this club. Part of the balance supplied by Buck Williams, not only on the offensive end, but especially off the boards.
I think he's everybody's power forward. They'd all love to have a Buck Williams because he's consistently banging on the boards. He gives you effort every single night, plays as hard as he can. I think the fast break style will help Buck immeasurably once they get it really truly in place with all the right players. Davey Wall thinks the world of that guy, and he's incorporated him into the offense and made him a big force.
Okay, for the Celtics, again, they have won 10 straight overall, and their record at home here is just starting to get to the silly stage. They're about 33-34-1. And Robert Parrish should be back today, which means Bill Walton goes back to the bench after an outstanding performance the other night.
I think Bill Walton relished the idea of starting the other night and really made his presence felt. His intensity was translated to the other ball players, and they came out banging hard right from the get-go and put that game right where they wanted it in the win column. I think Walton's ability coming off the bench in this particular game against a guy like Turner is not going to be too formidable for the Nets.
Okay, and to cap off the Celtics' 10-game winning streak, 26 straight at home, the play of Larry Bird. I've run out of superlatives trying to talk to him. Have you yet?
Larry Bird has just been everybody's everything, and what can you say about the guy? He's showed tremendous determination from the very beginning of the season where he had the bad back. Now you see he's got a smile on his face. If there's a guy at peace with his game, it's Larry Bird right now. It's really flowing.
Okay, coming up, the Nets and the Celtics on an Easter Sunday afternoon here at a sold-out Boston Garden. We'll be back with those starting lineups right after this.
Give me a light. A Bud Light.
If you just ask for a light beer, you never know what you'll get.
Case of light? No, Bud Light.
So if you want the less filling light beer with the first name and taste, don't just ask for a light beer.
Give me light.
Ask them to bring out their best.
A Bud Light.
Bud Light. Because everything else...
Thanks.
...is just a light.
This year, there's an exciting new option on the 1986 Chevrolet Caprice Rome. For only $20 more, you can move up to the full-size luxury of Pontiac Parisienne Brougham. For a limited time, special factory incentives allow your New England Pontiac dealers to offer air conditioning at no extra charge, a $750 value. That makes Pontiac Parisienne's price only $20 more than Chevy. And now get additional savings with 9.9% GMAC financing. Move up to Pontiac Parisienne from your New England Pontiac dealers.
Watching a storm, you easily forget that the sun's still shining behind the clouds. Just as in your life, storms come and go, but they don't change you. Not unless you let them. For almost 200 years, Fleet National Bank has been a resource people could count on in fair weather or storm. So if you want a bank that won't change direction with the wind, come to Fleet.
Worldwide.
Welcome back to the Garden, everybody, and everybody kind of settling in right now at the Boston Garden for a Sunday afternoon of basketball. A look over at the Celtic bench. Casey Jones, of course, the other night having his fourth 60-win season as a head coach. And congratulations to Case. Things just are rolling along pretty smoothly. And knowing Case, he's not going to rock the boat at all.
I wouldn't think so, because Case, well, and he deals with these players. You know, I think the move Robert Parrish not playing the other night was a concession to Robert that wasn't conceded to him in prior seasons under Bill Fitch, giving him a good long rest after a tiresome season. And more of a mental boost for Parrish, perhaps, than even a physical boost.
The backcourt is going to be Otis Birdsong and Kelvin Rainsy. His brother Clinton made a name for himself in the recent NCAA tournament playing for Cleveland State. There's Mike Jaminski, we talked about.
Player I like. I really like Mike Jaminski. He's a guy, I think, in the Lambeer category, perhaps even better than Lambeer, and doesn't get the recognition because he's been on the bench behind Daryl Dawkins most of the time. He's the more sensational player. Didn't quite live up to his wave expectations.
There's Dave Wohl, the first-year head coach of the New Jersey Nets, a former assistant to Pat Riley out in Los Angeles.
Paul Silas, an assistant coach, working with those big guys. Now it's inside players and banging on the boards.
Eckard from Pepperdine, 6'4", number 3, Dennis Johnson.
Dennis Johnson, author of a big game earlier this week. Against the Milwaukee Bucks.
6'5", number 44.
Danny Ainge will be the other guard.
The center is from St. Mary's.
Michael Ray was with this ball club. It was an awfully difficult matchup for either Johnson or Danny Ainge.
The Chief back in the starting role this afternoon.
6'10", number 32, Kevin McHale.
Kevin McHale at the one forward spot and Larry Bird at the other.
To Larry, this is the beginning of the season. You know, every game is the first game of the year.
Assistant coaches Chris Case Ford and Jimmy Rogers.
Enjoying.
And Coach Case.
Enjoying.
Jones.
I wonder if he got an Easter egg. There's a guy that did.
Earl Strom on the left, Jess Thompson on the right. Earl, who just gave you a wave. Veteran official.
Cost me a lot of money in my day, Earl.
He did, huh?
Yeah, but we always had fun. This guy right here is has great difficulty guarding Kevin McHale. He'll work at it, and should he get in foul trouble, that'll really hurt.
Buck really works at it. He really does. Because, I mean, he is not, maybe not the ideal physical specimen for a power forward. A lot of that is hard with that kid. He's maybe 6'8", about 215, 220. He's not of the Charles Barkley mold by any means.
No, but he's not as spectacular at Barkley, but he's more fundamental and very consistent.
All right, we're just about set to go here at the Garden. Again, a happy Easter to everyone, and hope over your Easter dinner you can have us on in the background here and check out the Celtics as they try to tie that win streak of the Minneapolis Lakers. Celtics going for their 27th straight at home.
I think the key matchup is Bird guarding Albert King. Albert has had problems with Larry Bird, but Larry Bird will have to end up guarding Albert, something that he doesn't do a lot against other teams. Guard that quick forward, kind of allows him to roam around, but Albert will score on him.
Right into Parrish, who spins easily by Buck Williams. So the Celtics decide to get Chief involved early here in the offense. Tied at two apiece. Backdoor Birdsong, nice save in the baseline. King will take it. Rebound Parrish, looking and finding Ainge on the outlet. Nets are back quickly on defense, four of them. Bird for three.
That's the ultimate trailer. Three-point play when the defense sinks into the paint.
Inside, Buck Williams couldn't get the handle, and Robert Parrish tipped it away.
A great position on McHale that time. They're going to use Jaminski to guard McHale.
Two.
And Buck Williams is going to end up defending against Robert Parrish. So there's two matchups inside that the Celtics ought to be able to make some hay on.
Jaminski now trying to work on the Chief. Long hook shot. Bird clears. Parrish running the floor very well. And he gets two.
Well, that bad back cleared up.
DJ just trailing Birdsong up the floor.
Birdsong has had those in and out years, mainly brought on because of injuries. Probably his healthiest season than any a season. I think he still missed a few games this year.
Kelvin Ramsey outside. McHale keeps it alive. Crowd wants Larry to go for three again. Takes it through, trying to dump it off, picked off, but gotten back.
And the Nets, ever ready to run, forgot the ball.
They do look like they want to get out quickly, don't they? Boston 4 of 5 shooting here in the early going. Again, they were looking for a Birdsong going along the baseline. Otis throws it up on a run off the side of the backboard. It'll be Boston ball. Birdsong looking for the foul.
He sure was.
Here's Otis's reaction. Danny wide open.
Davey Wall wants a timeout as the Celtics fast break really clicking.
9-12 to play here in the first, and the Celtics are out quickly by 6.
Introducing the Nissan Hardbody. It would still be the hottest truck in America even if it didn't come with fuel injection and a V6 engine. Even if it didn't have a roomier cab and a bigger, deeper bed. Because it comes with a feature that can save you up to $2,000. That's right, up to $2,000. It's called 7.7% financing. And it makes the hottest truck in America the hottest deal in New England.
We're your New England Nissan men. Yes, we can. Yes.
I realized something when I started Sullivan Tire many years ago.
Morning, guys.
It wasn't enough to offer the best parts and tires. My customers expected more. They wanted to walk into a Sullivan Tire Family Car Care Center and be helped with personal family service.
At any of our locations, you will be treated with our family spirit, because that's what Sullivan Tire is all about.
If you just ask for a light beer...
I'll have a light.
You never know what you'll get.
That's me packing the car. Best vacation ever. Here's Rock City, Texas, L.A., all in 3 days.
A Bud Light.
Here I am in Death Valley. That's me looking for water.
So if you want the less filling light beer with the first name and taste...
Wait, there's more.
Ask for Bud Light, because everything else...
Give me a light.
...is just a light.
That's me packing the car. Best vacation...
We're going to see, getting lost in transition, the right side of your screen as Buck Williams' arm around McHale. Parrish is guarding Jaminski, but Buck Williams is guarding Parrish. As soon as he sees the rebound has gotten, off he goes up the court. Buck Williams way behind Robert Parrish. A guard has to pick up Parrish, and that's too little and too late to stop this type of thing. So they're losing their defenders in transition with some good hustle up quick basketball by the big guys. Here we're going to see
Calvin Ramsey.
Calvin Ramsey making a move. A little pick and roll, and he can hit that outside shot now.
Ainge has got Ramsey on the defensive end. DJ's on Birdsong. Albert King from the perimeter.
Boy, Bird was right on his shooting hand and destroyed the rhythm of that shot.
Short, tried to keep it alive, and a foul is going to go on Bird as he slapped it away from Javinsky. First foul on the Celtics, and first foul of the game. 8:30 to play here, first quarter.
This way, Danny.
Turn around, Williams.
Boy, Kevin was right on that shot too. Buck doesn't lose his concentration.
Celtics go right at Jaminski in the form of McHale. Williams clears, and the Nets can get to within two here. Birdsong wants it. Rebound Parrish. Nice play by Danny Ainge to track down that pass. DJ will take it. Nail it. Tough shot. Dennis made it look easy. First hoop of the afternoon for DJ, and the Celtic lead is back to six. Williams trying to throw the screen on Ainge. Couldn't get enough of him. They go inside to Buck, and Kevin McHale had him by the arm.
Boy, he really sealed Kevin off, and a nice pass down the lane by Jaminski. And there's McHale already beaten as he was trying, anticipating the swing of the ball. Try to get out in front, and Williams used it against him. Smart play that time by both Buck Williams and Mike Jaminski.
New Jersey as a team is shooting 85% on the free throw line over the past week or so. They have been renowned to be a poor free throw shooting team in the past.
Oh, this Birdsong in particular.
Yeah.
Never suspect that he would be a poor foul shooter, but called Houston disease, I think. You know, everybody that came out of Houston would have trouble shooting foul shots.
Danny finds McHale top of the key, looking inside for Harris. Here's Stead. Robert the rebound.
Buck Williams turned him loose, went for the rebound, forgot about Robert. Robert timed it perfectly.
Picked off the floor by Harris. He's going to wait for a little help. Gets it from Dennis. Looking for Bird. Larry for three.
They really pushed that ball up there quickly, and people had to pick up people that they didn't want to defend against. Jaminski ended up with Bird. He certainly didn't want to have to go out there and play against Bird.
Bird has now made 71 three-point field goals on the season. The entire net team has 34. Obviously, they are not making as much use of that rule as Larry, huh? It's becoming more and more a part of the game, Tom, don't you think?
I think it's a great part of the game and has been missing for a long time because these defenses were designed to pack down in the paint for so long to stop the inside game that the only way to break it up is to hit the outside shot.
Ramsey, quick release, front rims it. Jaminski tracks it down. Loose ball foul is going to go on Buck Williams as he was pushing off underneath. First foul called on the Nets.
You know, a couple of years ago, Mike, in the playoffs, the Celtics and the Lakers, they were giving up 20-footers. Nobody was in within 5 feet of the guy if he had the ball around 20 feet. That's how packed in the defense has got to be. And what a great pass and move by Larry Bird. And here's a steal by Ainge.
Off to DJ on the cut. Tough shot. Won't go down. Parrish trying to keep it alive, but Buck Williams rushes it away.
That's an inside job from Buck Williams to get in there and bang. He's only 6'8", giving up several inches to Robert Parrish.
Nets are going to go to their bench here in a second. Birdsong wants it and kisses it off the glass. 4 points for Birdsong. 9 points Celtic lead.
To try and force Birdsong to the left, he's still got that great leaping ability yet to get the shot.
Easily over Williams. He's got himself 8 first quarter points.
Lost him once, twice on transition.
It's Intruder, Chrome on Chrome, stepped up seat, V-twin soul, but he don't care, he's got no doubt, it's Suzuki man, let it all hang out. The sound and the fury slung down low, lean and mean, he's on the roll, but he don't care, he's got no doubt, liquid cool, let it all hang out.
The 1986 Intruder, Suzuki man, Suzuki machine.
In the competition to build your office information system, one player is strong in computers, but not in communications. Another is strong in communications, but not in computers. At 9X Business Information Systems, we're strong in both, and we'll tie everything together in one system that works as simply as this. 9X Business Information Systems.
Basket will count, and a foul.
Sports Channel will bring you exclusive coverage of over 40 Celtics home games, plus home playoffs. And don't forget, Sports Channel is the only place to see all Celtics home games this season. Isaiah Thomas leads the Detroit Pistons into Boston on Wednesday, April 2nd at 7:30 to take on the Celtics.
Welcome back to the Garden, everybody. Mike Gorman along with Tom Heinsohn. There you see the Celtic front court, as usual, dominating their counterparts from New Jersey. Robert Parrish is a perfect 4-for-4 on the day, shooting 71% overall against the Nets this year. Robert Parrish is.
I think they may reevaluate that matchup situation, Jaminski guarding McHale and Buck Williams guarding Parrish. It's not working.
Bird gets a hand on it twice. Jaminski will take the open shot and hit it.
Sam, Mickey Johnson is one heck of a basketball player. They put him in there now for Albert King, and he's going to guard Bird, but 6'10", he can do a job.
Bird putting a hip into him, spins away, and the foul is going to go on Mickey Johnson. Good battle between the two, and they tap each other. Bird will be at the line. Second foul on the net.
Well, he did as good a job. He's trying to cut off the inside. That allows Bird to swing, but Mickey Johnson, with that size, is still able to get a piece of the ball, but he also got Bird's body. So he knows how to play low post defense. He's as good a defender as you're going to find at that size out on the open court.
That graphic scared me a little bit there, Tom.
Mm-hmm.
All right, we got through that. 39 straight free throws now for Larry Bird.
I tell you, the Celtics have exploited every weakness in the early part of this first quarter that the Nets offer.
Williams turns on McHale this time. DJ tracks it down. Second rebound from Dennis and pushes it up. Sees Parrish. Goes instead to Danny Ainge for a three-pointer. McHale won't go down, and Jaminski gets it out quickly to Birdsong. Now Cook on the break. That shot will bring rain.
Wow.
Bird is free. Off to McHale. Foul, Darwin Cook.
Two fast breaks. One didn't draw iron. The other one picks up a foul. But look how quickly Ainge spots the open man, Bird, who was kind of going off the court, had to lay it back to McHale, but with that outstanding speed, he was still having to be guarded by a little guard.
One. Kevin misses the first. 4:21 to play here in the first quarter. And Boston's lead is a dozen.
So that transition defense of the Nets not working at all. Jaminski, I think, should be staying with the man that's guarding him. And Buck Williams, stay with the man that's defending him. Make it easier for them to pick up their man up the other end of the court.
Ains, nice play as Danny stepped right in. Off to Parrish.
What a nice play by Danny Ainge. Made the entire three men of the Nets respect his potential move to the hoop. Pulled up, looked at the hoop, found Parrish.
Parrish yet to miss in this game, and Jaminski loses it on the end line. Albert King is going to come back in for the Nets. Fifth turnover on New Jersey. Boston's biggest lead. 14 stays that way.
They're just showing off right now.
Yeah, they are. Jaminski got it.
Well, he has got that wide body that once he plants it, you can't get around him.
List him at 260, and he's every bit of that. There's Bird getting free underneath and goes with the left hand.
Well, 11 years of experience was beaten that time. Mickey Johnson got his head turned.
Underneath, nice play, and Birdsong just really throws up a rock. DJ's the trailer. Wow, it's right.
That is nice, a fast break. And Darwin Cook was right at DJ, and DJ didn't blink an eye.
Just no contest so far. Mickey Johnson outside won't get out.
Whatever game plan the Nets had, it's evaporated.
Bird for three. Back rims with Parrish the rebound.
I'll give him another one.
Yeah, I thought he was going to toss it out to him for a second. There's Bird, back door. Misses outside, goes inside.
Davey Wall wants a 20-second timeout.
He should.
This is a carve-up job right now. And you look at Dennis Johnson, one-hand pass, and Mickey Johnson never even knew the ball was coming. They've been running this thing now for about 4 or 5 months, and they're catching their Bird's defender just totally out of the play. Here's the pass before that to Bird as Mickey Johnson was playing the pick, anticipating Bird coming out for the jump shot. Instead, Bird went the other way and left Mickey in the dust. I mean, you got your hands full with the way the Celtics look for Larry Bird.
Boston on an 11-2 run right now, and Bill Walton's going to come into the game. Kevin McHale sits down. Kevin has 5 points.
This is a disaster here on Easter Day for the Nets so far.
Buck Williams hits outside. 6 points for Williams. Trying to double up a little bit on the ball.
The Nets may have a little bit more success defensively as Buck Williams is going to guard Walton. Walton is going to guard Buck Williams.
How did Bird get that to Bill? Not sure how he did that.
Inventiveness. Creativity.
Jaminski inside. Won't go down. Tapped away. Picked up by Mickey Johnson. And Jaminski will get the easy two. Hoops are few and far between for this club right now. They're down 16 with a minute and a half to go here in the first quarter.
They've missed some very easy shots, the Nets. And their offensive patterns have broken down.
DJ.
Oh, a beautiful cut by Danny Ainge. Made the defense respect that cut. It opened up Dennis Johnson at the foul line. Smart pass by Robert Parrish.
Dennis hasn't missed a shot yet. Buck Williams, and the foul is going to go on Robert Parrish with the body. That'll be the third foul on the Celtics. Now the fourth.
You know, they are sitting up the other end of the court on the Nets bench, the coaching staff, in a very, very resigned fashion.
Buck Williams gets two.
Nice
speed for Mickey Johnson.
Sure was. I liked him as a player coming out of college. Great fast break player. A lot of people think that his head is a little fouled up.
He's been around.
But he had been around the horn and then some.
Oh,
through for two.
Well, Bird is doing a tune on Mickey Johnson's head right now. One time he cut him off at the pass, Mickey Johnson. Bird spun the other way.
In traffic, Buck Williams, and it goes down. Bird went down hard. See Larry under the basket getting up slowly. Buck Williams, the first net in double figures.
Mickey Johnson's doing a heck of a job of creating something. Feels he can put it on the floor against Bird and get into the teeth of the defense. He's doing exactly that, creating good opportunities for Buck Williams.
Celtics are going to take the shot clock down a bit here as we're in the final 15 seconds of the first quarter. DJ all alone. That one doesn't go down, and the rebound goes to Mickey Johnson. The Nets, whether they know it or not, have 5 seconds to get a shot off. Hook does, and gets it. Ainge, quick release. We have played a quarter here at the Garden, and the Celtics are in command. 38 for Boston, 24 for the Nets.
If you choose your tools as carefully as you use them, choose Master Mechanic Tools from True Value Hardware Stores. Master Mechanic Tools are made from superior materials to give you the performance and long life you would expect from a professional quality tool. True Value Hardware Stores are so confident of this quality that they will replace any Master Mechanic Tool that fails to perform as expected. And that means any tool from the wide line of Master Mechanic Tools sold exclusively by participating True Value Hardware Stores.
Bridging the gap between the quality gasoline America wants and the price they're willing to pay for it. Getty, more miles for your money.
If you wanted state line potato chips anywhere else but New England, you'd have to smuggle them. And they're so good that people try. You see, state line chips are flash cooked to a golden crunch. You can't get them anywhere else in the country, but people still try, smuggling across the state line.
State line potato chips.
The Whalers have been hanging tough in the NHL's mighty Adams Division by showing that they can skate with the best. And in fact, they're off to their best start ever. So be a part of some exciting hockey and join Sports Channel for exclusive coverage of the Whalers all season long and right into the playoffs. Adams Division rivals, the Buffalo Sabres, come to Hartford on Tuesday, April 1st at 7:30 to battle the Whalers. Join us for all the action at 7:15 with Dave Douglas and the Sports Channel pregame show.
Welcome back to the Garden, everybody. There are the first quarter numbers. Boston shooting 61%, winning the battle of the boards. Perfect. No turnovers for the Celtics in that first quarter. And they are very much in charge here. 38-24. Third time in the last five quarters against the Nets, they have scored 38 or more points.
That's defense, huh?
Yeah, I guess.
Well, the first thing I think that Davey Wall was trying to do with this ball club was create offense, fast break offense, change this rhythm.
Oh, nice. Really nice.
Well, Jeff Turner, welcome to Bill Walton. Look at Bird, that little smile on his face. Loves to be a receiver of a good pass as well as make a good pass himself.
Walton, Bird, McHale, Ainge, and DJ out there for Boston. Cook, King, Turner, Williams, and Mickey Johnson. Albert King with the rebound there. Loose. King again. Taps won't go down. Williams over the top. Walton the block. And Earl Strong says it was goaltending.
Sure looked like a good block to me. But the Nets get a little stingy around that basket now, banging hard for offensive rebounds.
Walton again to work on the rookie Turner.
Mickey Johnson, I'll tell you, he's as good as you're going to get defensively at that spot, and he's just having all kinds of problems against Bird.
Walton clears away the miss and is stripped by Darwin Cook. Heads up play by Cook.
Walton was flexing his muscles out there, and Cook stole his girlfriend.
Oh. And an illegal defense is called against the Celtics. Danny Ainge, I think, he's got the biggest smile on his face. Albert King blocked by McHale.
You know, they take so long getting into that patterns, the Nets, that the weak side of the Celtics defense can read it and know the first option. And the Nets aren't running their own offense as well as the Celtics are reading it.
Darwin Cook, the quick shot. They had the book, right?
Yep. No, I mean, they just saw the movie. Anticipating everything. It's just the Nets aren't alert to what the Celtics are doing defensively.
McHale trying to keep it alive, and we've got a foul that's going to go on New Jersey first here of the second quarter.
You know, that last block by McHale, when you saw him drifting, you fake it to Albert King, and you give it to McHale's man. It's an easy 2 points.
Jerry Seasting in, and Danny Ainge sits down on the Boston bench for the first time this afternoon.
Celtics just gambling on stopping the first option of every play of the Nets.
McHale looks and finds Walton. The finger roll won't go down, but McHale's tap does.
Finger tap by Kevin McHale.
Mickey Johnson to the hole. No. Strong rebound underneath. Blocked by McHale. Wow. Loose ball. Seasting up to DJ. Runner. Tap doesn't go from Bird. Loose ball. Who's got it? Good hustle by Seasting and Dennis to get it back. No harm, no foul. And Seasting can't handle it on the end line. Officials are letting him bump a little bit out there.
Yeah, a little bumping going on. Maybe we'll maybe shave off his mustache after this game. Anything.
Well, this is a playoff club. Looks like they will draw Milwaukee or Philadelphia in the first round. King can't hit. It is a playoff team. I don't make the rules, Tom. DJ, still perfect.
Harry Bird just picked off two men to allow DJ to get that shot off.
Biggest Celtic lead, 20, with 9 minutes to play in the first half. Cook, Seasting the board. Alley-oop doesn't go, almost went in, but there's McHale, the trailer, and the foul will go on Turner.
Wow. Having things go your way.
I guess.
It's really having things go your way. The long pass blocked and ends up in the hands of McHale. Yeah, you watch. And there's a nice finger in there to stop it, but the ball bounds all the way out to McHale at the head of the key, who then promptly takes it in and gets fouled.
Scotty Wedman's coming up off the Boston bench. The Celtics have run off 7 straight points here to extend their lead to 21. And Larry Bird with 17 will sit down. That's the best thing that's happened to the Nets today.
They have just been outstanding here in this first half, the Celtics. Excellent. Picking a part of the Nets defense and anticipating on the Nets offense.
Jaminski, the hook doesn't go.
Celtics are leaving no room for error by the Nets.
It's the second turnover there on Boston. New Jersey is 2-for-14 shooting here in the second quarter.
The inside game has been gobbled up. They've either missed or had him blocked.
Jaminski off the Wedman miss. No place for Cook to go. Oh, throws it away across court. DJ tracks it down to Seasting to Wedman. It's the layup. Boston bench is not going to let Scott forget that one.
That is not what is known as a bunny that Wedman missed. And it wasn't the Easter Bunny.
Beeston looking for help. Out of bounds, Boston ball. Good play by Jerry not to touch it again. Here comes Albert King back in, and Mickey Johnson will go out for the net.
I think layups are easy, huh? I can remember one game I missed five layups in a row. Nobody around me. I run an embarrassing field.
Jaminski to the hole, and he's fouled by Dennis Johnson on the way in. He'll have two at the line. Second foul on the Celtics here in the second quarter, and the first on DJ.
They'll get it up quickly, as we mentioned in the pregame show. And here's Jaminski going strong, and DJ making sure that he doesn't get the two. Puts Jaminski at the line.
Jaminski recently set a net record with 44 consecutive free throws. He's made 64 of his last 65 at the line.
But here's a player with character and a guy that you'd want to have on your club. I think ultimately this team will develop maybe next year, with or without Darryl Dawkins. If they get a decent player in the draft, I think they're going to be all right.
Walton's turnaround won't go down. Carlisle through for the rebound. It's knocked out of bounds and will be Boston ball. 16-point Celtic lead, 7 minutes to play first half. Boston led by 14 at the end of one. And had it as high as 21 here in the second quarter. Cale deep. Birdsong, the king. The runner goes.
All right.
Nice basket by Albert King. And Casey Jones is going to take a little time out here. The Nets get it back down to where it was after one. 6:43 to go in the half. Boston by 14. Eight straight for the Nets.
Pontiac, among the hottest selling cars in General Motors 86 lineup, and Brand Am is the hottest Pontiac of them all. At your New England Pontiac dealers, you can buy the exciting new Grand Am Coupe with air, AM/FM stereo, and more for just $98.74, and that includes freight, or lease it for as little as $193 a month. Hurry while selection's at its best. Get the Pontiac hotter than all the rest. Grand Am, from your New England Pontiac dealers.
This whole thing started in my kids' playroom at home.
Fleet National Bank is looking for businesses that are looking to grow.
Fortunately, I found a bank that really listened to my ideas. I mean, I knew there was a market for my synthesizers. My bank stuck with me till I found it.
Fleet's already helped thousands of businesses all across New England.
Today, thanks to Fleet, my kids have their playroom back, and I've got one of my own.
Fleet National Bank, New England's business resource.
If you just ask for a light beer...
Give me a light.
You never know what you'll get.
What I wanted... Bud Light.
So if you want the less filling light beer with the first name and taste, ask for Bud Light. Because everything else... is just a light.
Join Tom and me for our next exclusive telecast here on Sports Channel. That'll be coming up next Wednesday night, April 2nd, as the Celtics tip off against the Detroit Pistons. Isaiah Thomas and company follow all the live action from the Garden, beginning with our Celtic pregame show at 7:15, exclusively here on Sports Channel. Robert Parrish is back in, along with Larry Bird. Carlisle and Seasting the guards. Walton up front with Bird and Parrish. Hill, on his way through, had it stripped. Seaston trying to jump it off and got flattened. And Cook gets the Nets back to within 12. And it's as close as they've been in a while.
It's showing me a little spunkiness here, these Nets. They're hanging right in there. They took the best shots that the Celtics could throw at them in that first quarter, and they're still coming hard.
Celtics turning the ball over with more regularity here in the second. King hits outside.
That's the fast break of the Nets in action. Three, four guys up fast. Find the open man. They all can stick it from about 18 feet.
12 straight by the Nets, and Bird buries a three-pointer. It calms the party down a bit. Birdsong around his screen, and he nails it.
Starting to feel it right now, these Nets. And Celtics better play a little defense, particularly against the fast break. They ruled the boards in that first quarter. They've given up some rebounds and steals.
Excellent steal there by Cook. Birdsong again, the pull-up. Not this time. Turner, nice follow. Walton got him on the arm, and the rookie out of Vanderbilt to go to the line.
And only two Celtic defenders up there to do anything about it. Here's Cook, comes right in, takes it away from Walton, and off they go. But Jeff Turner, the trailer, comes up with a nice rebound and then forces the foul on Bill Walton.
Turner has put on some weight since he came in. I think I just called him a rookie. This is his second year.
No, he might not be a bad backup center. He's not 6'10", but he is a fine shooter. And last year they had him out at the forward spot. I remember in one game we did trying to guard Larry Bird, and that was an injustice to Jeff Turner. Just did not have the mobility even to get close.
Bird uses the screen. Fine, Parrish.
I tell you, he read Jaminski moving over to pick up McHale. That's how alert he was. He was one step ahead of the Nets defense.
Cook will try. Goodness.
And this is a miss.
Okay. Dale is stripped on the way up. No call. Jaminski left open. Parrish made him change the shot, and McHale's got the rebound.
Look at how many wide open shots they're getting now in this quarter, the Nets. Celtics not really hustling back on defense in this second quarter.
Cook is covering Bird, too. And an illegal defense is called against the Nets, so they're one apiece now in the ballgame.
Jeff Turner, who went over that imaginary line that runs up the middle of the foul lane. Once you do that, you got to double team the man with the ball.
Bird, three more. 23 now for Larry in the first half.
In your Easter bonnet. We got 3 points upon it.
Cook pushing off on Ainge.
Wow, what a shot by Albert King. I mean, that was a knuckleball. He was just afraid that Bird was going to get out of shooting hand. Bird wasn't even near it.
McHale in a lot of traffic, can't hit.
We're on three.
Celtic bench looking for a travel call on Cook that he'd get it. Rebound to Bird. Luka to Parrish. Too long. Birdsong and King, two on two. Jaminski the trailer, nice move.
And two of the Celtics never got past half court. Now this is a direct relationship to that first quarter of great play. They feel they've got the Nets on the ropes. Instead, the Nets are rallying and coming back. Got to play four quarters of basketball.
Bird wants it, and he is fouled on the way up. The crowd give Earl Strom a hand for calling one. And Nets are going to take a timeout. 2:42 to go here in the half. Boston by 13.
Introducing the Nissan Hardbody. It would still be the hottest truck in America even if it didn't come with fuel injection and a V6 engine. Even if it didn't have a roomier cab and a bigger, deeper bed. Because it comes with a feature that can save you up to $2,000. That's right, up to $2,000. It's called 7.7% financing. And it makes the hottest truck in America the hottest deal in New England.
We're your New England Nissan men. Yes, we can. Yes.
In every field, there are people whose jobs require specific skills that only a specialist will have. And that's true in business, too, where 2 out of 3 executives surveyed preferred specialized temporary help. When your accounting and bookkeeping staff is shorthanded, call AccountTemps, the temporary accounting and bookkeeping specialist. AccountTemps professionals are usually slightly overqualified, so they do the job better and faster with almost no break-in time. Accountemps, the specialist in temporary accounting and bookkeeping help.
Out in front, the ball to Windham, stolen by Scott. Good drive all the way. Scott puts it up. It goes in. Oh!
We're knotted at 27, approaching 2 minutes to go first quarter.
Yes, who's going to get credit for that?
Scott back-to-back buckets. Maybe that'll be another sign.
Pistols, long jumper, no good. And Griffith goes for the rebound, but Lieber comes down, and from a setting position, he makes it.
Unbelievable.
Lieber on his back, shot it and made it.
America's game. It's fantastic.
Going to see Larry Bird read the defense on this particular play. A little pick and roll. The normal play would have been for Bird to give the ball to McHale, but he spots Jaminski moving over to pick up McHale. Instead, gets it to Jaminski's man, Robert Parrish, who was wide open. I mean, that's heads up. Looking at the defense. And here comes the Nets with what they do best, that fast break. And they've got some good players to run the trailer spot, Jaminski being one of them, of course, Buck Williams the other.
Well, he continues perfect at the line. He's got 25 points now in the afternoon with 2 minutes and 39 seconds to go here in the half. Mickey Johnson, Parrish owns the boards, up quickly to Bird at half court. 8 rebounds for the Chief already in the game. DJ back to Larry, kept it alive, but New Jersey comes up with the ball. Mickey Johnson just stopped the contact and got it.
I'll tell you, he took it as strong as you're supposed to take it against a big man. Cut down his reaction time so Parrish would never be able to really get up and block it. Forced the contact. There's Parrish trying to go straight up, but banged into him. I like this guy. You know, he's kind of a wild-eyed guy.
Well, I was talking to some of the Net people there, and they told me that about 2 or 3 weeks ago, Mickey and Dave Roll had to go behind closed doors for a little while to straighten out a few things.
Yeah, well, Mickey is that type of guy, you know, and that's been his problem, is getting along with the coaches. And but he's been around for 11 years,
so. Well traveled. DJ front rims it. Loose ball, out of bounds. It'll be New Jersey's. Birdsong wide open.
A good pick that time by Jeff Turner. You know, this isn't a bad lineup they have right in there right now. Jeff Turner playing power forward. He still hasn't developed a real inside game yet.
Bird comes around a screen and found Parrish, and the foul is going to go on Otis Birdsong on the way by.
Larry Bird just read the defense. He doesn't look at his teammates as much as he looks at the opposite jersey color to see how many are around him and to find out where the weakness is. You know, it's all a blur out there when you're playing the game. And instinctively, you've got to read the defense. Like Bob Cousy was a great reader of the defense. Never really expected his players to do the right thing when a man left his teammate. You know, that guy was expected to get to the open spot. Cousy get you the ball. Bird does the same thing.
This is near steal by Bird on the baseline. I've heard it said, Tom. You tell me if it's true or not. I've heard Cousy used to throw the ball to where you were supposed to be as opposed to where you were. Is that true?
Pretty much. But everybody was on the same wavelength with him. Bird is really great at reading the defense, too.
Mickey Johnson will try and hit. Final minute here, the first half. Boston's lead a dozen. They led by 14 at the break, got it to 22, and then the Nets made a run. But the Nets have yet to get this back in single figures. Bird wants it. Little flip shot, doesn't go down. Larry does. Turner.
4-on-2, and two of the big guys never got back. Keep that pressure at you, and that may have an effect in the second half. Celtics will have to get back I'm sure Casey Jones will be talking about that at halftime.
Whatever, the Nets have made a game of this when it didn't look like it was going to be a game. It's 10 right now, the Boston lead.
Boston, in the second quarter here, has virtually given them a lot of easy opportunities.
8 second quarter turnovers, Tom, for the Celtics, after 0 in the first quarter. DJ hits again, and Dennis is in double figures at 10.
They're shooting the lights out with their type of shots, but their defense right now for the Celtics is practically non-existent.
Nets taking it down for the final shot, and Dennis Johnson with 4 seconds is called on a reach-in.
Well, there's an old adage, you know, at this time of the season, I'm sure Casey Jones addressed that point before the game. Let's get out there and establish what we do early.
Oh. A couple of people were open. The layup is missed, but Turner's there with the follow.
Right.
There were a lot of blue jerseys open there on that little time. Dennis trying to match his feet of the other night. It didn't go. It's a 10-point game at the half. So the Nets keep it interesting anyway. 62-52, Boston.
Bridging the gap between the quality gasoline America wants and the price they're willing to pay for it. Getty, more miles for your money.
Before you get roped into one supplier for your business communication system, consider this. Now there's a company that takes only the best products from the best manufacturers and ties them all together in one communication system that works as simply as this. 9X Business Information Systems.
Boy, what a beautiful ride. Come into any one of my Sullivan Tire Car Care Centers for fast, friendly service on tires, shocks, battery, and brakes. Meet Vector, Goodyear's newest all-season radial. Its innovative crisscross tread provides year-long traction and long-term wear. So come in to any one of my Sullivan Tire Car Care Centers, say hello to Vector, and enjoy the ride of your life.
Sports Channel has the most comprehensive thoroughbred action seen anywhere. First, racing from Suffolk Down comes your way with a complete recap of the day's races and inside news from the track. Catch it 5 days a week. Next, thoroughbred action from New York's finest tracks runs 6 nights a week with the best cards and most exciting races. And Inside Racing, TV's most comprehensive racing recap and analysis show, premieres every Tuesday with a review of the national...
beginning.
The Consumer Information Center at Giant Food contains...
Here's to you, Beechwood Age, for that clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
Boston Celtics of the 1950s and 60s created the greatest dynasty in the history of professional sports. 11 championships in just 13 years. These years are the subject of The Celtics Dynasty, a special 8-part series appearing on Sports Channel's Fleet Bank postgame show. Join host Kurt Jacobson and the men that made Celtic history as they relive legendary moments such as the time that Havlicek stole the ball. That's the Celtic Dynasty, only on Sports Channel.
The Statue of Liberty's torch is out. The beacon of freedom to all the world is in this workshop, severely damaged by weather, pollution, and age, as were many other critical parts. They must be restored or replaced, and that takes money. If you still believe in her, help finish the job. Let the world know we will keep the torch burning for generations to come.
Send your contribution to The Lady, Box 1986, New York.
The Boston Celtics Halftime Show is brought to you in part by Designs, who feature Levi's Action Slacks for unsurpassed comfort. See Levi's Action Slacks at Designs, the East Coast home of the 501 jeans.
Welcome back to the Boston Garden, everybody. Mike Gorman along with Tom Heinsohn. A chance to remind you this copyrighted telecast is presented by the authority of the Boston Celtics and is intended solely for the private non-commercial use of our audience. Any publication, reproduction, retransmission, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this game without the express written consent of the Celtics and Sports Channel is prohibited. Announcers on this broadcast are selected by Sports Channel and approved by the Celtics. Ainge, McHale, Bird, DJ, and Parrish are out there to begin the second half for Boston. Jaminski, Ranzi, who didn't play much after starting that first half. Birdsong, King, and Williams out there for the Bucks.
Let's see how
make them the Nets. They're not the Bucks. They're the Nets.
Let's see how they match up defensively. You're going to match up Buck Williams guarding McHale. That should make it easier for them to get at the Celtics up the other end. Jaminski's going to guard Parrish.
Larry, little up fake, got King in the air. Danny will try. Jaminski the rebound, and the Nets can get this thing down to eight.
Boy, they played good defense that time on the pick and roll play. Casey Jones saying, hey, you guys, get that work ethic back there. Ooh, tough defense.
Ranzi loops it inside, and in for fall away, too hard off the glass. Here comes DJ.
McHale made him change the arc of that shot.
Celtics want to go inside to McHale right now. Kevin knocks home the follower. Kevin joins the double-figure club now with 11. Boston's lead a dozen.
Well, looks like the Celtics are going to work Buck Williams down that low post.
So Buck gets some himself, and Connell's going to either go on Bird and take a shot.
Look at how far in the paint he is. Bird has to come down and help out. Picks up the foul.
Buck will be at the line for two.
Well, Larry Bird listened to the lecture at halftime.
I bet he always does.
You know, a fast break team counts on the opposing big men to break down a lot of stages of a game, not to quite hustle back on defense. In the tail end of the third, beginning of the fourth quarters, Celtics stopped running back on defense, their big people, in the middle of the second quarter.
Bird looking to go back door. McHale was trying to find him. Outside, too.
The old accordion offense. When the defense is in, hit from outside. When the defense is out, get it inside and score.
Bird's on. McHale gets a piece of it. Right, Williams coming away with it. Good hustle by Williams to get that ball on a massive Celtics. Jaminski, little jumper. He got himself a dozen. And the Celtics stay with a double-figure lead, but right on the edge of it. DJ. And a whistle away from the ball, I believe. Let's see who the foul is going to go on.
I'll tell you, this is pretty interesting what the Celtics did that time. On a double team, they picked off the rotating man that was going to go at Johnson. Danny Ainge did that. DJ had a wide open shot.
Danny's open again. 4 points for Ainge now in the game.
Why did the Nets go double Dennis Johnson that time?
I don't know.
Didn't make any sense.
Williams McHale right on the ball that time. Williams wanted the foul. DJ is the open man in the corner. Bird. Watch Birdsong go by, loops it into Parrish, and Buck Williams is going to be called with the pushing foul. Larry made that foul happen.
You know, all you have to do to get a pass through is read the defense, and if the guy is leaning just off balance a little bit, the speed of the ball will get by him. That's what Bird did exactly that time, put it in a perfect place because he saw Jaminski leaning the wrong way.
McHale got Williams in the air and hits the jump hook.
Buck is renowned for going for fakes.
Mickey Johnson into the ball game now along with Darwin Cook. Johnson will fire.
Bird says, so what?
No big deal. Larry for three. DJ, nice offensive rebound. Then he had a thought of a three-pointer. Took his time and nailed it.
Boy, they're just demoralizing the defense of the Nets now.
Getting a lot of open shots, aren't they?
Well, they're reading it so well. I mean, that time McHale saw the man rotating to the first pass, first option, got it to the second man.
Birdsong, but Dennis Johnson went whizzing by. Nice move in the baseline, and he's going to pick up a foul. Good move by Danny, and the Chiefs saw him coming.
Being outside to take this pass, you're not allowed to come from out of bounds. Well, I guess he didn't look for an instant that he did, but there it is, trapping it on the boards. That should have been goaltending, too.
Jaminski was given the foul, his first, the third on the Nets here in the third quarter. Bill Walton in, Robert Parrish will sit down. Parrish has got 14 points on the afternoon.
Well, he got it up and going quickly, too, Robert Parrish.
Yeah, soon as he played well against this New Jersey team last year.
As soon as the Chief sees that Buck Williams is going to guard him, boy, he said, this is going to be my night.
Williams looking to work on McHale now. Waits for Birdsong to come around.
Great switch out that time by Kevin McHale.
Technical foul is just whistled on Otis Birdsong, who was right in the ear of Jess Thompson all the way up the floor. I mean, in his ear.
Take a look at what he thought was a foul. Here's McHale right away after the pick, jumps out there. And boy, it looked like he had a piece of the ball. But that is what is known as anticipation. Not an instant of hesitation for McHale to switch out.
It was funny because as Thompson came running up the floor, I mean, Birdsong was like stride for stride, and his mouth was about an inch away from Thompson's ear. 7:43 to go here in the third. Boston's opened it up again to 16.
I realized something when I started Sullivan Tire many years ago.
Guys,
it wasn't enough to offer the best parts and tires. My customers expected more. They wanted to walk into a Sullivan Tire Family Car Care Center and be helped with personal family service.
At any of our locations, you will be treated with our family spirit, because that's what Sullivan Tire is all about.
Where's the Yellow Pages?
Shirley? You know who's got the Yellow Pages?
Over the years, one book has been in more offices helping people throughout New England find more goods and services. The 9X Business to Business Yellow Pages. It's always there when you need it.
When you buy a Nissan 300ZX, you buy a legend. A tradition of many Z cars. Each meticulously made to the tolerance of an expensive watch. You buy a racing heritage unmatched by any car in its class. But most of all, when you buy a 300ZX, you buy Nissan. For this car expresses what we believe a quality sports car should be. Awesome. The name is Nissan.
But first, they have to defeat the Buffalo Sabres. Follow all the action on Tuesday, April 1st at 7:15 p.m. as the Whalers try to eliminate Buffalo, only here on Sports Channel. That's April 1st, this Tuesday night.
And they have been a hot club, the Hartford Whalers.
Yeah, they really have. Making a serious run at the playoffs. Serious run. DJ. Birdsong, kind of in a stalemate. Danny's the open man.
And wide open. And Dennis Johnson knew it. No fast break opportunities for the Nets here in this quarter. They're having to go more and more to their set offense.
Sure are. Which is not too mysterious here for the Celtics. DJ, off to McHale. That was a good pass. It'll count and foul. A tough pass, but a good one by Dennis Johnson.
Bird just puts his hand up. Jaminski, poor pass. And DJ comes up with the ball and looks to see if his wing is covered. And then just measures where he can get the ball to McHale. A nice, strong layup by Kevin McHale.
Six assists for Dennis Johnson in the game to go along with his 10 points, about five rebounds. McHale completes the three-point play. He has 16. And the Celtics are starting to stretch this out a bit again.
Go away, go away.
Understated.
Good defense.
Buck Williams powers up for two.
Well, somehow or other, Dennis Johnson ended up on Buck Williams.
Tried to dump it off to Walton. Birdsong got it ahead to Cook. Cook will take it in for two.
And Ainge very upset with himself for that turnover.
17-point Celtic lead as we approach the halfway point here of the third quarter. Celtics are really spread out as they isolate from McHale. And then foul. It'll be two, and McHale will be at the line. Cook will pick it up on the reach-in.
Only made his move to go down and double on Kevin when Kevin turned around to look square up to the hoop.
Too late?
No, but they're trying to vary it. You know, as soon as they go down on the reception of the ball, it's much easier for the Celtic big guy to read the defense. It's those sneaky little doubles that happen either as you're putting the ball on the floor or when you turn around and look at the hoop. That causes the problem sometimes.
Boston by 18. Led by 14 after one. New Jersey made a rock to get 10 at the half after the Celtics were up as high as 22. Dennis Johnson's going to pick up that foul.
It's about time I got a foul on a jump shot. I mean, they're clobbering me here.
Fouls a little more frequent here in the third quarter than they were in the first half.
Well, this is an adventure for this kid. Oh.
43% shooter against the Celtics last year at the line. Look at that. He's 55 on the season.
I mean, that's atrocious. Good an outside shooter. There's something mental about that situation. The psychology of shooting foul shots for this kid is gone. He doesn't believe in himself or something.
Bird off to McHale. Made up his mind halfway through that one. 19 now for Kevin. 4-4 shooting for McHale here in the third quarter. Buck Williams. Jaminski couldn't follow. McHale was trying to help out. And technical fouls going on Dave Wall over on the New Jersey bench.
Is that fire in the eye? Wow.
We're going to walk the other way and shoot him first. Bill Walton Walton going over to chat with Casey Jones. He's not coming out of the game. And Larry continues his streak at the free throw line. And he's got 29 points now in the afternoon. Bird now the fourth leading scorer in the NBA at 26.3 a game. Dantley, Wilkins, and English are all right around the 29.1. Real battle there for the leading scorer in the league.
So what?
Well, you know.
That's my opinion of the top scorer.
One. No, but I mean, with the exception of maybe the Hawks. Well, the Denver's playing well. I mean, that's something for those fellas to kind of like fight out amongst themselves.
Yeah.
Keep their season interesting.
Larry Bird is one of the few Celtic players that have been on winning teams that has ever been up that high in the top 10 scorers. Very rarely has there been a Celtic in the top 10.
I think there's any doubt Larry could lead the league in scoring if he wanted to just concentrate on it. Bird trying to keep that in play. Nets will get it back.
Danny Ainge had to rush that shot. But he can sight the basket, get his rhythm together. He invariably makes them.
Mickey Johnson deep in the corner for two.
Johnson from Otis Birdsong.
Nice range for 6'10
forward. I'll tell you, I'd be playing Mickey Johnson ahead of Albert King against Larry Bird. Mickey goes out, and he rebounds. And
Bird has got Birdsong on him. Strom just looked and smiled at Bird. No contact, he said. Buck Williams loses it out of bounds the other way.
That was Birdsong. Threw the ball when Buck was looking to turn around and get back in on the board, thinking that Birdsong was going to use the pull-up jump shot. A little miscommunication.
Slapped away by Cook, who has very quick hands. And blocked by Walton, but a foul is called. Measured that for about 8 or 10 steps. I mean, he knew exactly what he was going to do.
I'd say a Darwin Cook tried to foul him up a little bit, took it to one side, and then reversed it. But this is determination by a big guy. Look at him put his head down and just go after him. That was a close one.
Cook misses the third foul on Bill Walton, the fourth on the Celtics here in the third quarter. Cook is 10th in the league in steals per game.
Darwin Cook. I wonder how he got that first name, Darwin. That's kind of an unusual first name.
It is. Bird outside. 31 for Larry.
Ho-ho. Ho-ho, Toto.
16-point Boston lead. 4 minutes now to go here in the third. Birdsong behind the Jabinski pick, and he nails it.
Jabinski saying, more of that. Come off me more. I'll get you free.
DJ deep in the corner. Kale, good follow.
Step right in front of Jabinski. I mean, that's aggressive offensive rebounding.
Kevin has 10 points on 5-for-5 shooting here in third. Interesting series of fakes there by Jabinski. Served the purpose.
Well,
it looked like he was in a rocking chair there.
Looked to me like it should have gone one more pass because Mickey Johnson was absolutely open. It's the team concept that sometimes in losing teams is not evident.
Walt wants it. Can't hit off the glass. Kale slaps it away. It'll be New Jersey ball.
You know, ever since Mikhail came back to the lineup, he's not been as big a part of the offense as he was before the injury. You know, he's getting about 20 shots a game or thereabouts.
Birdsong for two more. Birdsong's having a big night. 18 points. Came in averaging 15 a game. And the Nets crawl back to within 12 again.
Yeah, spunky. I like Mickey Johnson. Keep him out on the court there.
Well, Albert King, they paid an awful lot of money for him, and that's one owner saying, you got to play the guy we paid.
Boston ball.
And Mickey Johnson mad at himself for doing that, and so is Davey Wall saying, let's get back in that little room and huddle again.
2:23 to play in the third. Celtics by 14.
This year, there's an exciting new option on a 1986 Chevrolet Caprice Brougham. For only $20 more, you can move up to the full-size luxury of Pontiac Parisienne Brougham. For a limited time, special factory incentives allow your New England Pontiac dealers to offer air conditioning at no extra charge, a $750 value. That makes Pontiac Parisienne's price only $20 more than Chevy. And now, get additional savings with 9.9% GMAC financing. Move up to Pontiac Parisienne from your New England Pontiac dealers.
This bug's for all that you do.
They said this city was through. You said, no way.
Each day the spirit's growing. Your pride is really showing. You, you make America work. And this bug's for you.
Here's to you. Beechwood Age for that clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
This bug's for you.
This season's Adams Division play is the hottest in the league. Don't miss hockey's finest teams when they visit the Hartford Whalers in the final home games at the Hartford Civic Center Coliseum. Feel the excitement, the tension, the power. Feel the thunder of the National Hockey League.
SportsChannel follows the Peugeot Grand Prix. That's skiing. Join us on Thursday night, April 3rd at 8 o'clock. The finals from Stratton Mountain, and it's exclusively here on SportsChannel. The Grand Prix.
The Peugeot Grand Prix.
You got it. Used to be, you were the man with the Italian soccer a couple of years ago.
Right.
I couldn't handle that.
Right.
French I can handle. Walton wants the ball. Looking inside for Bird. Quick shot by Danny. Tough angle. Foul was called. Jess Thompson did not want to call the foul until Mickey Johnson went down. Then he called it. That was a good example, Tom, of the old no harm, no foul, and then the harm came and he blew the whistle.
Yeah, I was about to lose the ball out of bounds, yeah. So the whistle blew.
Do you like that? Do you like officials to be like
pretty much,
let the bump go?
Well, unless you're in the scoring position, you know, when you're down inside, that's where that philosophy gets carried to its ultimate, you know. And more often than not, they let you foul the man without and the guy doesn't score. You know, and
uh-huh.
The foul really has an impact. All you need is a little bump underneath there. They're off balance.
Nice spin move by Dennis Johnson, and he rolls it in. First points of the third quarter for DJ, who has a dozen. He's taking their time in their half-court set here. Birdsong's the cutter. Nice move.
Nice pass from Mickey Johnson, too.
Birdsong, now the leading New Jersey scorer with 20.
You know, it's funny how the politics of a team works, too. You know, Mickey Johnson... really a heck of a player, in my opinion. When they signed an Albert King to a big, big contract, and the owner's sitting there saying, why isn't the coach playing him more? Mickey Johnson is saying, I'm better than him. And then you end up with a morale problem.
We started this quarter with the Celtics up 10. The lead is back down to 11. Casey's going to take a little time out here. 1:03 to play in the third quarter. The Nets, again, refusing to go away in this ball game, and they trailed 92-81. Let's take a look at these last two baskets here.
Hey, Mickey Johnson now almost loses the ball here. Nice cut by Birdsong. Eludes DJ. Walton doesn't get over there quite quick enough and has to turn him free on the board. Beautiful heads-up play by Mickey Johnson. And here comes another one. Fast breaks. Don't take this team for granted, the Nets, because they can make them back quickly, that fast break style.
Aren't they looking at either Philly or Milwaukee in the playoffs? Let's not talk about Milwaukee. Let's talk about Philly. They got a shot against Philly, you think?
Well, without Daryl Dawkins, I'm not so sure, but we're not quite sure whether Moses Malone is going to play for Philadelphia either. He suffered a fractured eye socket and is supposed to be out for the remainder of the season. Whether that includes the playoffs, I would assume it does. And I'd have to pick the New Jersey Nets, in that case, over the Sixers.
All right, racing from Suffolk Downs will not be seen tonight due to the holiday. The track will resume its racing schedule on Monday, March 31st, and that'll be at 7:30. So no racing from Suffolk Downs tonight. It'll be coming up on Monday night at 7:30. So you would like the Nets to be filmed.
Yep. As they're constituted right now, I think without Moses Malone, they got real problems. Clem Johnson is nowhere near as effective a center as Mike Jerminski is. And I think they don't have any backup center if Moses goes down and Clem has to start. Who's going to be the backup center? At least the Nets have Turner, who's been trained into the role for a while.
Yep, there he is right there coming into the ballgame. The New Jersey bench has outscored Boston 22-2 this afternoon. The only 2 points off the Boston bench coming from Bill Wall.
Well, Mickey Johnson came off the bench, and so did Darwin Cook, so that's pretty good.
The foul is going to go on Mickey Johnson, who doesn't like the call. He thought Bill Walton took him down, and Earl Strom said, nope, other way.
How long do I have to endure these type of things? Mickey Johnson was just saying, Earl Strom, I've been around 11 years. This man has really made his mark in Boston. That was really a tribute the other night. After the starting performance, he was lifted from the game in the fourth quarter, and boy, these fans here at the Boston Garden just gave him a round of resounding
sure did.
Hand and a
yep.
Applause of approval. And, wow, terrific.
I don't think anybody is going to challenge Larry Bird for popularity in Boston, but Bill's going to wage a serious battle on second place. Fans really like him.
Jeff Turner is a real fine outside shooter. He doesn't have the inside game, but they may be able to do something with that in the playoffs.
Winding down the third quarter. DJ, count it, and a foul.
DJ says, I can play in his low post, Otis. Otis Birdsong, pretty good defensive player. And there's Mickey Johnson stopping Bird. And here's DJ getting good position on Otis. Lifts him. That is one of the tough areas to play defense in, down in that low post. Because a man, if he lifts you, gets your knee in just the least little bit, you're out of the play. You really have to know who you're playing against down there. His moves. Anticipate.
Celtics going to get the ball back with about 10 seconds, maybe more. Birdsong shot out of bounds. New Jersey will have a chance to come back. They'll take the final shot of the quarter. They're down 13. 6:83. Cook just walking around. 10 seconds now. Use a corner pick. Mickey Johnson with four. Puts it down. Walton rebound to DJ. Dennis turns. Has a line on that one, just short. We have played three at the Garden. The Celtics have added 3 points for the halftime lead. 96 for Boston, 83 for the Nets.
I wasn't even sure I could make a go of it.
Fleet National Bank is looking for businesses that are looking to grow.
I knew our thinking was sound because we have the right kind of experience. But it was our bankers who really opened my eyes to our potential.
Fleet's already helped thousands of businesses all across New England.
It's sort of funny thinking back. The people at Fleet thought we could pull this off before we thought we could. Thank goodness they were right.
Fleet National Bank, New England's business resource.
When you've been in a neighborhood as long as I have, customers become more than faces. They become friends.
It's great to know that you've given families a familiar place to go for reliable hardware and sound advice for a lot of years. There's a comfortable hometown feeling that can't be bought or imitated. You just know when you fit in somewhere, when you really belong, no matter what changes go on around you.
We've got what it takes, true value.
Boy, what a beautiful ride. Come into any one of my Sullivan Tire Car Care Centers for fast, friendly service on tires, shocks, battery, and brakes. Meet Vector, Goodyear's newest all-season radial. Its innovative crisscross tread provides year-long traction and long-term wear. So come in to any one of my Sullivan Tire Car Care Centers, say hello to Vector, and enjoy the ride of your life.
Boston Celtics of the 1950s and 60s created the greatest dynasty in the history of professional sports. 11 championships in just 13 years. These years are the subject of The Celtics Dynasty, a special eight-part series appearing on Sports Channel's Fleet Bank postgame show. Join host Kurt Jacobson and the men that made Celtic history as they relive legendary moments such as the time that Havlicek stole the ball. That's The Celtic Dynasty, only on Sports Channel.
Welcome back to the Garden, everybody. Mike Gorman along with Tom Heinsohn. We've got 12 minutes of basketball left here on an Easter Sunday. As you see, shots are now even, at least shots taken are even at 72 apiece. Boston a slight edge in shooting. Slight advantage at the free throw line. New Jersey doing a nice job on the boards, out rebounding the Celtics by one. And New Jersey taking pretty good care of the basketball, Tom, after about five. I think they had six turnovers in that first quarter, so they've only turned it over three times in the second and third.
And Casey Jones has not used his bench.
No, he hasn't.
As liberally as he has in prior games. The only real substitutions for any significant minutes has been Walton.
Good point. He's in there now for McHale. Jaminski, jump hook, takes his time, it goes.
Parrish is zeroing in on that jump hook, too. He knows Jaminski, when he gets to that side of the court, is looking for that jump hook.
Parrish out high this time, watches and finds DJ the cutter. Danny can't get it to go down. Good strong rebound, Mickey Johnson, who handles the ball well on the break himself.
There's
a foul from Bill Walton.
Mickey Johnson is a fast break player. Anybody been able to harness that enthusiasm that he brings and downright nastiness when he's out on the court has been able to get a lot of good basketball out of Mickey Johnson.
Ball's in play.
Three out of five shooting for Mickey Johnson at the line so far in the game. And it's a nine-point game. It's as close as the Nets have been since the first quarter.
Watch out, Celtics.
Bird wants it. Won't go down. Jaminski the rebound. New Jersey can get to seven.
Nice defensive rebound that time by Jaminski.
Kelvin Ramsey. Turner now looks for Johnson, the cutter. Got the basket and a foul. Nice play by the kid.
He's playing power forward, and with that extra beef and the outside shot, Bill Walton has to respect that. And you're going to see Jaminski now really block out beautifully. Robert Parrish just carved out the space for himself. And you watch up the other end. Bill Walton gets caught leaning and allows Turner to put some speed on Walton and take it strong with the left hand, his natural hand.
There's a fifth foul on Bill Walton, who goes to the bench, and Kevin McHale comes in. Turner missed the free throw. He's got 11 points on the afternoon. This is as close as it's been since the score was 14-8.
And this looks like a pretty solid unit they have out there, these Nets.
Bird.
They elect to let Mickey Johnson play him one-on-one, which is, as we all know, one tough assignment.
Mickey Johnson, a hook shot. DJ's there. Battles with Mickey Johnson. It'll be Boston ball. Mickey hung in there.
could have been a foul, too.
Yeah, could have been.
There's DJ, but Mickey Johnson said, it's my ball, too, pal. And there he is, and DJ falls over the top.
Wow.
No foul.
Seasting is in now for Danny Ainge. Clear out again. Ramsey comes on the double team. That leaves Jerry open.
So much more confidence when a big guy posts up a little guy. He knows that the little guy is not even going to get close to the ball. Mickey Johnson saw DJ guarding him. Easy two.
Bird had it slapped away as he went through. Goes to the floor for it. And the foul, I believe, is going to be on Ramsey over the top of Bird. I have not seen in the 30-odd games we've done this year too many loose balls on the floor get away from Larry Bird.
Has a spin move to the middle this time. Last time he spun to the baseline. Doesn't happen. Bird still scrambling for the ball.
Yeah. Not about to let that get away. McHale leans in, gets it on Turner, and draws the foul.
That little move there ought to really do a tune on Jeff Turner's head. He had him played for the fall-away jumper, the move to the baseline. A little fake just created enough room for Kevin to slide by, scoop it underneath.
Celtics get it back up to a dozen as we approach the nine-minute mark in the game. Ramsey will fire.
Ramsey will fire a lot.
Really quiet in this one, though. Just 4 points. Buck Williams is getting back up off the bench, and that pass is picked off, stolen back by DJ, who hurt his right hand doing it, and popped the finger. And knocked away by Birdsong out of bounds. DJ holding his right hand. There he is. Gonna shake it off, I think. He's got a couple of fingers taped together, as you can see. Robert looking for a little help and then retreats.
Albert King is just laying his body all over Larry Bird.
DJ, a couple of fakes. Bird's there. Nice.
What a rebound. Just held his man, Albert King, underneath the hoop.
And the Nets are going to take a timeout. 8:06 left to go in the game. Boston by a dozen. We'll be back.
Some companies rent you a car, and that's it. But Hertz is with you all the way, with customer service representatives to speed you on your way. Computerized driving directions to help you find your way, and 24-hour road service in case you get stuck on the way. So you have a choice for your money. You can rent from a company that just gives you a car, or rent a car that gives you a company. Hertz, you don't just rent a car, you rent a company.
We have a problem. They're here. We're here. Why? They're pre-selling better, following up sales better, and still reducing cost. How are they doing this? Look familiar.
Use New England Telephone more than your competition does, and watch what happens.
We're the one for you, New England. New England Telephone.
This bug's for all that you do. Somehow you always come through. Going. Your pride's really showing. Nobody shines like you. Yeah, you make America work, and this bug's for you.
Here's to you, Beechwood Age, for that clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
This bug's for you.
Well, Welcome back to the Garden, everybody. As you can see, the Celtics have picked up their shooting here in the fourth quarter. So have the Nets. They're just not shooting it too much.
Hmm.
4 minutes gone, three shots. You want a few more than that, don't you, T?
Well, we got those at timeout.
King outside. Tries to go back. Gets it. Here's Buck Williams. And Bird. Buck Williams kept it alive. And it'll be New Jersey ball. Credit Buck Williams with keeping New Jersey's possession there.
I tell you, he really scraps.
Kelvin Ramsey hits another one. Harris. And the foul is going to go on Jaminski.
Well, Robert Parrish taking a page out of the book of the Nets. Just took off up the court. Larry Bird, ever alert to the fact that Parrish will run against his opposition. That pass was right on the money, and Jaminski is not the swiftest of foot. Parrish feels he can beat him up the court.
Robert has yet to score a point here in the second half. Here's one. Nets with 7:30 to go have a chance to get this down into single figures again. Boston has dominated all the way, but the Nets have been hanging around. And it's a 9-point game. 20 points in the afternoon from Mike Jaminski. Feasting penetrates on the baseline. Kevin too long with the jumper. Parrish clears. Robert had a thought of going right at Jaminski. Now he's looking for a cutter. Finds McHale. Nifty pass by Parrish, but Kevin couldn't put it down. Now quickly Birdsong. Albert King gets the basket.
Well, with King on the wing right now, they've got a speed advantage. I think Davey Wall, that's the ace of spades up his sleeve. A little speed in the fourth quarter.
Blocked by Jaminski on Bird. Chance for the Nets to get to five. Ramsey won't go down. McHale the rebound. Up to Feasting at half court. Ahead to Parrish. And the foul will go on Albert King, who just wrapped him up.
Now that should be a deliberate foul. And Casey Jones is up off the bench. He was behind the man.
You see Case
still arguing, and Earl Strom is telling Casey that he had the ball. Looked like he had nothing but double zero.
Yeah, sure did.
And a deliberate foul here would have given Robert the two free throws and the Celtics possession of the ball. Now you watch. Look at that hold there. Come on now. That's not deliberate. What is?
He's got them both.
You know what, people that say there's too much of a penalty on that deliberate foul rule and that the officials won't call it. That was a perfect illustration of that point.
Bird got a hand on the pass.
A deliberate foul. Other people felt that the penalty ought to be 3 chances to make two. It's not as severe. Giving the team the two shots and then possession of the ball, the official would be more prone to call that.
Birdsong, tough shot, won't go down. There's Williams again on the board. The double dribble. Buck is set.
He wants a foul underneath, and Mickey Johnson does too.
Again is all over Bird. Rebound out to Darwin Cook. 3-on-2, New Jersey break.
4-on-2.
Kind of forced the shot a bit, but he picked up a foul from Feasting.
There is a team really not knowing what they have. You know, they got out there fast. They had a 4-on-2. And Cook was not in complete control over what's to do on that situation. They should have just waited for the fourth man up the trailer, slipped it to him, and it would have been a layup. And that's what Davey Wall is telling him right now.
Come on, let's get a blue.
The guy's got to hold that ball up, keep it in the middle. It ended up the ball on the side. It never got back to the middle to create maximum pressure on the two-man defense.
Cook hits the first of two. He's got 8 points on the afternoon.
Those are the type of things that Michael Ray Richardson used to do so well. Read the defense on fast break situations. Watch out, gang.
7 point game.
Hold the hand.
Feasting quick pull up. Goes. They had the shot and took it. And Dave Roll calling a play off the New Jersey bench. 5:10 left to go in the game. Boston by 9. On the King.
Tell old Albert's got the green light to shoot the ball.
Was that the play we just had?
That was the play, I guess, huh? Get the ball to Albert and let him fire.
Again, King and Bird are really going at each other, top of the screen. Bird is trying to get him to clear out. Cook comes on the double. Larry sneaks through, is short with it.
Well, that was a good double on the dribble.
That's a walk. That's for letting a few opportunities go by here. 12 turnovers now in New Jersey.
Davey Wall very upset with Albert King that time.
Mickey Johnson is up off the bench. Bird is like pointing out to Jess Thompson, top of the screen, what's going on with Albert King.
Foul is going to be on Larry Bird.
Celtics not over the limit. Third personal, as you see on Larry. The Nets will inbound. Mickey Johnson's coming in. Albert King's going out.
I think that's a wise substitution because Albert King had nothing but the net in view instead of the team concept. Cost them potentially 4 points. One bad shot and a walk. Good thing Mickey Johnson has been doing is putting the ball on the floor.
Buck Williams can't get it to go down, stays with it. Zielinski this time, he got it.
Mickey Johnson has been able to put the ball on the floor against Larry Bird and penetrate and create either easy passes for baskets or good offensive rebounding opportunities for the Nets.
DJ. Rebound to Cook.
Excellent defense that time by the Nets.
Birdsong. 24 for Otis Birdsong. It's a 5 point game. 110-105.
The interior defense of the Nets has stiffened.
The Celtic home court streak as threatened as we have seen it here in the past couple of weeks. Bird the up fake. And what do we got? Foul is called. And Larry will be at the line. A hand from the crowd who was wondering if anything was going to be blown Boston's way here. Mickey, Nets are over the limit.
Mickey Johnson just crowded Bird too much that far out on the court. Bird alert to the potential of using some speed against Johnson just wheeled off to the baseline. I tell you, he takes advantage of everything.
First one Larry has missed in about 40. 37 straight, I believe, coming into today, so he's up around 44. Birdsong, tough move.
Well, I tell you, he got by his shooting hand side, took it strong to the hoop, and McHale, before he saw what happened, there was Birdsong making a shot.
DJ wants it, won't go down. Mickey Johnson tracks it down ahead, too far for Cook. And Dave Wall turns around and claps his hands and points to Mickey Johnson. He made the right play. This didn't work out right.
Right play, wrong pass.
2:36 to go in the game. It's down to four.
Nissan introduces the hard bodies, the hottest new trucks, all fuel injected. With the lowest factory-sponsored truck financing, 7.7 annual percentage rate. Save as much as $2,000 in interest on this top hard body with the biggest engine in any compact truck. 7.7 saves as much as $750 on this tough new Nissan with the most power of any leading standard compact truck.
New Nissan hard bodies, new hard bodies.
For a limited time only.
Mom, have you seen the Yellow Pages?
Did you look in the closet?
Dina, do you have the Yellow Pages?
Uh-oh, check the den.
Dad, where's the Yellow Pages?
Look upstairs.
I looked already.
Over the years, one book has been in more homes, helping people throughout New England find more goods and services. The 9X Yellow Pages. It's always there when you need it.
By Walt, off to Bird, Larry, to McHale for two. Basket will count, and a foul.
Sports Channel will bring you exclusive coverage of over 40 Celtics home games, plus home playoffs. And don't forget, Sports Channel is the only place to see all Celtics home games this season. Isaiah Thomas leads the Detroit Pistons into Boston on Wednesday, April 2nd at 7:30 to take on the Celtics.
When a team in the fourth quarter that likes to use offensive pressure basketball gets a rebound, they count on getting a speed advantage on you and beating your big men up the floor. That time, Mikhail, the only man in the picture, has ceasing gambled on the outlet and lost the gamble. Now watch Birdsong just get by Dennis Johnson. Mikhail over there to help out, but still Otis had his shooting hand free.
All right, Boston ball back live. 2:30 to go in the game, the Celtics by four. Bird wants it. The Nets can get to two.
And something's happened to Mikhail. And
Mickey Johnson too. I think they might have cracked knees. Well, I think they might have cracked knees. I can't, because Mickey Johnson's got the same problem.
Yeah, it's the kneecap on Kevin McHale. I was hopeful. Let's see the replay and see what happens. There's McHale coming in.
Yep. That's exactly what they did. They cracked knees right
cracked
there.
Cracked knees, and there's Kevin just... Not until we gained possession, or they gained possession, and McHale was limping up the court, and Mickey Johnson is hurt. So nothing happened. The sting is gone. Back to playing ball.
Yep, both of them stay in. Johnson to inbound. 2:19 to go. The Nets can get to a hoop. The Celtics, 26 straight wins at home. The streak is on the line now. In a two-minute game, Boston's up four. New Jersey's got the ball.
Drama, Mike. Drama.
Been seeking some here these past few weeks, haven't we? Birdsong. Mickey Johnson will try it. Air ball. Parrish has got it. Big trip for the Celtics here if they can get a hoop. New Jersey, not a good three-point shooting club. Larry will take it. Yes.
Mickey Johnson backed off and Bird accommodated.
On an Easter Sunday, Larry has got 40 and has just set a Celtic record against the New Jersey Nets for most points scored. 1:42 to go in the game. Nets want a timeout. Boston is up by a half dozen. Larry Bird broke Larry Bird's record of most points against the Nets. Easy on the typist.
You watch Mickey Johnson on this. He has to pop out behind the pick. He races out, and he's got his right foot out and not his left hand. All right? He puts his right hand up, and that is like a shooting window, a window to shoot through. If he had had his left hand up, he might have been able to bother Bird. That was his best chance, but Bird, plenty of room to get that shot off.
Sixth time this year that Larry has had 40 or more in a game, the 20th in his career.
Oh, yes. It's an Easter Sunday.
256, I think, consecutive sellouts here at the Garden.
Everybody after this game will probably be heading down to the Quincy Market and see what the other people are wearing for the day, besides the green.
It's a nice idea.
I'll tell you, though, the Nets, with this style of play...
They showed me a lot here today. They still may show me more, too, before we're through.
Eventually, may turn into a heck of a basketball team. They lost their prime ball handler. That hurt them a few times. And particularly that long pass by Mickey Johnson to Darwin Cook, I think it was, way over the mark, would have been very, very helpful. But don't count these guys out.
Albert King jumper and Albert King travel sure hurt.
That hurt, too.
All right, let's see what the Nets are going to go to here.
It's one-by-one mistakes that add up to... the big L.
Williams will take it inside. Won't go down. Oh. Rebound. Parrish. Foul call.
What a terrific rebound over Mickey Johnson, who had the inside position. Now look at Parrish just come right over the top of Mickey Johnson and pull it down and then fight off the hordes. Get out of my way.
Third personal, as you see, on Mickey Johnson. It won't matter too much down the stretch here. Chief is going to have a couple.
I like it.
Nineteen for Robert Parrish. Boston's lead is now 8. Danny Ainge is called for a foul off the ball.
Why did he see that?
What?
Inside of the court.
Buck Williams, quick turnaround, won't go down. Kaminsky the rebound this time, and he hits the little jump hook.
Buck Williams that time jumped and never got his shoulder squared to the basket. And Mikhail didn't even have to get his hand up.
24 points out of Mike Kaminsky. Quite a fine game.
Solid player. Done it.
Chief. Foul is called. It's going to be Boston ball.
Yeah, Robert Parrish. I mean, that's expressive for Robert, okay?
Said a
wonderment.
Lot.
All right? That is expressive. And there's some more expressiveness. Like Casey Jones.
Otis Birdsong hurt himself trying to cover DJ there. Dennis will take it behind the Parrish screen. 17 for DJ. And the Nets want a timeout with 53 seconds to go in this one. And Boston leading by 8.
Well, the Celtics hit some key outside shots, Mike. Bird, and now that one by DJ. And didn't look like, that Parrish move to the hoop. Certainly should have put Parrish on the foul line again. But
they got 2 out of the trip and got a few more seconds off the clock, which I think they'll take in exchange.
Yep.
40 points for Larry Bird to lead all scorers. 24 for McHale. We can take a look at the shot by Dennis Johnson here. 19 for Parrish and 17 for number 3.
Now watch Parrish just set this pick on Otis Birdsong. And Otis got one in the chest.
Yeah,
an elbow in the chest.
Robert made sure it was a long trip around that pitch, didn't it?
You are going to fight below the pick. You are going to contend with me. I'm going to put my arms up, and you'll have to run around my arms.
Now you see the front court scoring of the Celtics, 86-68 over New Jersey. No real surprise there.
You know, when McHale guards Buck Williams, and Buck gets the ball in the low post, McHale is such a good defensive player. And I think Buck is a little intimidated. He feels that he has to get an extra amount of leaping ability going in order to get over McHale's long arms. And he's really forcing shots down there. There's not a natural flow to what he's doing in that low post. And they need some low post points. Jaminski is not a great low post player that's going to get you all those points out of that position all the time. And normally, Buck Williams will contribute mightily in that low post department. Not this afternoon, however.
Albert King back in for Mickey Johnson.
Buck Williams to inbound. Comes to Jaminski. I think they're going for three. Albert King takes it quickly.
Oh, okay. Albert King didn't even look at the basket before he shot the ball.
Cook got the follow. DJ with some open floor in front of him. Gets away from the double team. It's going to have to be a serious foul to be called here today. Crowd wants Larry to shoot it. Parrish. Darwin Cook knocks one home for three. 5-point game with 17 seconds left, and Albert King fouls Danny Ainge in the backcourt. Dave Wohl is about to suffer a defeat here. Three times in NBA history, a team has won more than 27 straight at home over a two-season span. Philly, Minneapolis, and Seattle did it. The Celtics are about to tie the record set by those Minneapolis Lakers back at 49 and 50 with their 27th straight win at home. Cook again for three. Cook will try again for three.
Lloyd three, hoping to get fouled. Kick those legs out there.
And Ainge is fouled immediately by Cook in the backcourt with 3 seconds to go in the game. 120 to 117 the score. Boston by three, and Ainge will be back at the line. Only two current NBA players were born when the Minneapolis Lakers set that streak back in the 49-50 season.
Who's that?
Irving and Jabbar.
Is that right?
And you were a sophomore at St. Michael's High School in Union City, New Jersey.
Gee. That's going way back.
Casey Jones was a year older than you. He was a junior out of Commerce High School in San Francisco. And Red Auerbach was coaching at Tri-Cities. How about that? Let's throw it away. Down five with a second on the clock. And that is going to do it. Boston. 27 straight now at home. Tying the Lakers of the 49-50 season for the best record in a row at home. We'll be back in just a minute. 122-117, the final.
This bud's for all that you do.
Carlos, I need 100 of these by Friday.
My friend, I'm retired. My son is running the business now.
Oh. You know just where you're going. It's true, your pride is showing, cause you make America work, and this bud's for you.
Here's to you, Beechwood Age, for that clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
Pontiac, among the hottest-selling cars in General Motors' 86 lineup, and Grand Am is the hottest Pontiac of them all. At your New England Pontiac dealers, you can buy the exciting new Grand Am Coupe with air, AM/FM stereo, and more for just $98.74, and that includes freight, or lease it for as little as $193 a month. Hurry, while selection's at its best. Get the Pontiac hotter than all the rest. Grand Am, from your New England Pontiac dealers.
Sports Channel continues its exclusive coverage of the thoroughbred scene with Inside Racing. Every Tuesday night, hosts John Imbriel and Harvey Pack go beyond the finish line for an in-depth look at thoroughbred racing. Inside Racing features race recaps from the best parks across the country, interviews with the jockeys, trainers, owners, and people behind the scenes, and previews of upcoming events in the world of racing. Sports Channel's got thoroughbred racing covered. Inside Racing, just another pod of the best of Eastern sports. Sports Channel.
McGruff, the crime dog here. Tony thinks he's gonna walk home alone. Tony's wrong.
Tony! What are you doing? Walking off by yourself.
Good thing it was his friends, because teenagers are the victims of over 2,000 violent crimes by strangers every day. You can help stop it. Learn to protect yourself and your friends. Find out more. Write to McGruff, the crime dog, and help take a bite out of crime.
Welcome back to the Boston Garden, everybody. There is the final score. The Celtics winning it 122-117. Don't forget to stay tuned for the Fleet National Bank postgame show. That's coming up with Dave Douglas immediately following this game. In this wrap-up here at the Garden, Mike Orman along with Tom Heinsohn, 27 straight now at home. They'll go for the record Wednesday night against the Pistons.
Well, I think it was an outstanding effort by the Nets today, could have easily been blown out of here. And it shows me that Dave Wohl has got control of this basketball team, even though they've had innumerable problems during the course of the season. And this team looks to me like they're going to be gutsy in the playoffs, and if I were Philadelphia, Milwaukee, or whoever they're going to play, I'd be worried about this Nets team.
All right, we have an Eastern Clothing player of the game in each of our broadcasts. No doubt about who it is today.
Oh, Mr. Larry Bird. I mean, he did some unusual things today. There's Mickey Johnson saying, I'm going to send him, help me to the middle. Nobody helps him. He bumps him to the middle, and there you go. I mean, Larry Bird just did a total tune on whoever guarded him. I mean, they tried to physical him today, bounce him around. They tried to finesse him. Nothing worked.
Easton Clothing offers the fastest alterations in the business. We offer the finest selection in suits and men's clothing and tailor them at your convenience. So try Easton Clothing today. Larry Bird, the Easton Clothing player of the game. And as also, we have a Nissan Major Motion play of the game, and that too involves Larry Bird, this time teaming up with Bill Walton. Walton and Bird and DJ and Bird are really making things lovely out here to call, aren't they?
You just watch Jeff Turner's hands on this play. He's got both hands on Bill Walton's back. And that allows for a passing angle to Bird, who beats Mickey Johnson, who never knows the ball is there. He's got his hands up, but just a perfect pass. With your hands down like that, Bill Walton says that's automatic pass time.
All right, coming up on Wednesday night, the Detroit Pistons and Isaiah Thomas are going to be here at the Garden. Tom and I will be here, too. Tell me about Detroit, a team that many felt this year was going to knock on the door of the big three or four. Are they there or close to it?
Well, they started out very strong, and all of a sudden they went to a big, big tailspin. A lot of controversy whether they're going to retain the services of Chuck Daly. At one point in the season, they rebounded back. They put Joe Dumars, the rookie, in the backcourt. I thought that gave him a new type of weapon. Two point guards, two good ball handlers back there, two penetrators, great problems. Took a lot of pressure off Isaiah, and I think the team started to gel a little bit. The bench also started to come in, and they found the way to use certain people, and they become pretty formidable down the stretch.
Should be a good game?
I think so.
Okay. We'll be here on Wednesday night. That'll do it for this portion of the broadcast from the Boston Garden. Again, the final score, 122-117. The Celtics win it by 5. For our statistician, Dick Leip, our producer-director, Jim Edmonds, and my partner, Tom Heinsohn, have a happy Easter, everybody, and we'll see you on the postgame show. Boston Celtics basketball brought to you by Budweiser. Beats with age for that distinctively clean, crisp taste that makes Budweiser the king of beers. For all you do, this bud's for you. By your New England Pontiac dealers, home of the Hot Ones for 1986. By Fleet National Bank, where innovative services and individual attention give you more bang for your money. Fleet is New England's financial resource. By the 9X Yellow Pages, it's always there when you need it. By Nissan. Test drive the all-new Nissan truck hard bodies at your Nissan Datsun dealer now. By True Value. The more you've got to do, the more you need True Value hardware stores. We've got what it takes. And by Sullivan Tire, Family Car Care Centers. At Sullivan Tire, you'll be treated with our family spirit, because that's what Sullivan Tire is all about.
All right, stay with us. Straight ahead on the post-game show, we'll review the highlights from today's Easter shootout between the Celtics and Nets. We'll also take a look at the Sixers game down at the Spectrum with the Dallas Mavericks. From hockey, we'll size up the Adams Division race and check on tonight's schedule. Only 1 week left in the regular season of the NHL. From college basketball, we'll have highlights from the women's title game played in Lexington, and we'll preview the men's championship game in Dallas. And also, part four of our series on the Celtics dynasty.
The Boston Celtics post-game show is brought to you by Fleet National Bank.
Hi again, everyone. I'm Dave Douglas. The last time the Celtics played on a major holiday, they got beat. Remember that Christmas Day fiasco at Madison Square Garden in New York? Well, Easter Sunday is a different story. The Celtics dominate the New Jersey Nets. They win by five, but New Jersey did make it interesting coming down the stretch. Let's return to the Garden now, rejoin Mike Gorman and Tom Heintz. Now, there's a strong possibility, what with only four home games left in the season, that the Celtics will go this year with only one home loss.
Makes our job certainly pretty easy here at the Garden, doesn't it? That's an excellent point you make, Dave. You know, it's hard with a team as good as the Boston Celtics are to say that they possibly had any point that was a turning point in the season, but a lot of people do feel Christmas Day was, let's call it, a pivotal point. Do you agree?
I think that was a total embarrassment, but the key point in the season that I believe was a turning point to believe them in themselves as a great basketball team was when Kevin McHale was out for the 14 games. And on a real crucial road trip out on the West Coast, that they came through, won four out of seven, and came back with a new style of play that caused a lot of problems for the rest of the league.
Haven't figured it out yet. The rest of the league hasn't anyway. Let's take a look at the numbers from today's game. Again, New Jersey made a game of it, as you said they would at halftime, Tom, after they were down big. 46 of 91 shooting for Boston, 51%. The Nets got 100 shots off, made 49 of them. Boston winning it from the free throw line, as you can see. The Nets a surprisingly large rebound advantage there, Tom.
Well, Jaminski and Mickey Johnson and Buck Williams are board bangers, and I'll tell you, Mickey Johnson, to me, is a key player on this team, as opposed to Albert King, especially against the Celtics, where nobody's going to turn off Larry Bird. And Albert King, and Bird seems to be able to go out and do a number on Albert King. Mickey Johnson made a lot of good things happen out there today.
All right, let's take a look at the individual numbers. Of course, Larry Bird was right on top for the Boston Celtics. He finished with 40 points on the game. And on the other side, it was Birdsong with 26, Jaminski with 13, Parrish, the leading rebounder for Boston. It is very, very quiet here at the Boston Garden right now. I think there are about a half dozen people left in here, and in about 2 minutes, the number's going to be two less, Dave, so we're going right back to you right now.
You going to give me a prediction on Duke and Louisville tomorrow night?
I like Louisville.
That makes two of us.
All right, gentlemen, enjoy your Easter down at Quincy Marketplace. Enjoy the Easter bonnets.
We'll
see you Wednesday night when Detroit comes to town. All right, the long homestand comes to an end today. The Celtics were flawless during this long stretch at the Garden. Now it's on to Cleveland for a game Tuesday night. At the Garden today, Easter Sunday, the Celtics exploited Daryl Dawkins' absence from the Nets lineup, and they beat New Jersey by five. The game you saw here on Sports Channel today, the Chief back in the starting lineup after not suiting up Friday night against the Bullets. Robert Parrish wasted no time getting off to a quick start in this game. It was a dominating first quarter for the Green today. Larry with one of his three first-half three-pointers. Meanwhile, New Jersey struggled. Here they turn the ball over. All right, Danny Ainge with a nice steal. He will combine with the Chief, who is racing just as good as ever. Robert slammed that one home. Parrish got off to a very fast start today. Larry Bird had 25 first-half points. He got two off that DJ assist. Bird will hook up with his partner, Bill Walton, right here. This put Boston up by 18 in the second quarter. Walton cans the 10-footer. More from the veteran pair. Walton will find Bird. Little backdoor number. These two have patented that play. The second half, the Celtics held the lead.
More and more to their set offense.
Sure are. It's not too mysterious here for the Celtics. DJ off to McHale. That was a good pass. It'll count and foul.
Doesn't have the inside game, but they may be able to do something with that in the playoffs.
Winding down the third quarter. DJ, count it, and a foul.
DJ says,
But New Jersey staged a comeback. This baseline move by Otis Birdsong pulled the Nets to within four with 2.5 minutes to play. Looked like we could have some dramatic finish at the Garden today, but Larry Bird kept the holiday victory safe. He stuck that jumper late in the game. Bird finished with 40 points. That, as you see on the graphic, a new Celtic record against New Jersey, breaking guess whose record? Larry Bird, you got it. So, the Nets made it close down the stretch, but Boston held on for the victory, 122-117. The Celtics have now won 11 straight games, 27 straight at Boston Garden, and as we were talking with Mike Gorman a moment ago, only four home games left in this regular season. The Celtics may well go the entire season with losing only one game at home. That was the December 6th loss to the Portland Trailblazers.